Here comes the.
Y'all don't really want it like that. Yeah.
Here comes the.
G'day folks, welcome to another Brothers Weekly Wrap, proudly brought to you by ASN Cairns for all of your supplement needs. Reunion weekend, huge couple of days for all of the former old boys of the club. Kickstarted Friday night with our 100 club over at the Leagues Club. Wonderful to see such a turnout of former Brothers players dating all the way back to the early 60s. This weekend, we not just being reunion weekend, we also pay special attention to the year 8 premiers. So with our 1968 reserve grade side, our 1978 under 20s premiers, and also from 1988 both reserve grade and A grade who are premiers, and then the 2008 side where 15 of the 17 players were in attendance. So big night Friday night before backing up for Saturday. As we mentioned, a Super Saturday under sixes all the way through to A grade. Kickstarting the games for the day, our Kennedy's Better Home Living Colts coming away with a pretty commanding 56-6 win over Kangaroos, with fullback Hamaso Tabawai Fidow grabbing himself 5 tries in that victory. It really is a great shame that with QRL restrictions that he's not able to further apply himself in open age, because he's got more than enough ability to be playing A-grade rugby league. Despite only turning 17 later in the year. Moving into the Tropic Wings reserve grade match, really entertaining game of reserve grade footy. Both teams neck and neck and a full time. It was a 14-all draw. Unfortunately, old Anthony Baby Stuff Satrick wasn't able to slot one from out near the sideline with a couple of minutes to go. I know he's a little bit dirty on himself for his stab at the footy, but it did set up a quality finish and probably a rewarding result for both sides, coming away with one competition point. Moving into the NQ Petro A-grade battle. In front of all of those old boys, we hit the ground running. Tries to the old stager, Robbie Swain, in front of his class of 08. Teammates was wonderful to see before Lockie Parmenter scored on the other edge. And when George House crossed, we went to the break at 18-0 up. Unfortunately, second half was more ruse before a late penalty goal to George House sort of cemented our victory, eventually coming away with a 20-10 win. Half-time entertainment was something to behold. Special mention to our former old boys getting out on the paddock with some wonderful examples of high ball catching. Not so much for holding your feet, but certainly holding the footy. But again, a massive shout out to all of our old boys, and especially those premiership winning sides, for getting along and making a wonderful afternoon of rugby league here at Stan Williams Park. Turning attention this week, we play host to the high-flying Mossman Port Douglas Sharks, currently sitting in third position on the ladder. The Sharkies, they'll come down here with certainly plenty of confidence that they can take away the points on the weekend. The game being played in the unfamiliar time slots of 1:30 for reserve grade and 3 p.m. for A grade, but on Saturday here at Stan Williams Park. Hopefully a dry track, clear skies will make for a wonderful afternoon of entertaining footy. So until next week, go the fish.
Get him. Come on.
We played overnose. They offered a 6-1 to win a grand final. Roger put his $5,000 on it. Now this is midway through the season, $5,000. We go out to grand final, we win it. Poor old Roger whacked them $30,000 in the hand.